Hello and welcome, this is Jeet Dolakia and you are watching It's Tomorrow News. Cyclone Bulbul latest updates. The very severe cyclone Bulbul made a landfall over Indo-Bangladesh coast on Saturday night at around 8:30 p.m. yesterday night with a maximum wind speed of 110 to 120 km per hour, gusting up to 120 km per hour. At present, it continues to move in northeastward direction. Bulbul brought in very heavy rains all along the Indo-Bangladesh coast along with strong winds. Even the capital city of Kolkata had to bear the brunt of the cyclone with heavy rains and winds gusting to the tune of 50 to 70 km per hour and 3-digit rain at the Dum Dum Airport. In the last 2 days, the city has recorded very heavy rains. As of now, one casualty has been reported in Kolkata due to the storm. A 28-year man lost his life when an uprooted tree fell on him. All flights leading to Kolkata Airport were diverted until 6 a.m. today. Also, around 1 lakh people have been evacuated from low-lying coastal villages and island in Bangladesh. Now, the threat for West Bengal is over as the cyclone has weakened and will become a deep depression soon, moving towards northeast India. Ahead of the landfall, on Saturday night, the department had advised the maritime post of Bamongla and Paira to hoist Great Danger Signal No. 10. All fishing boats and trawlers in the North Bay have been asked to remain in a shelter until further notice. The storm made landfall near Sagar Island in West Bengal's South 24 Parganas district with its status downgraded to severe from very severe at about 9 p.m. on Saturday as the gale wind speed dropped to about 115 to 125 km per hour. It took about 3 more hours for the entire storm system to move across the shorelines. Meanwhile, an elderly man died in Potokhali when a tree fell on him house as the storm ripped through the coastal district and another man was killed in Khulna. Severe rescue team including NDRF are on standby in West Bengal and Odisha in case of any eventuality. The cyclone intensified into a very severe cyclonic storm and triggered heavy rain in parts of Odisha and West Bengal on Saturday. The IMD had issued orange warning for November 9th and 10th for Odisha district, Balasore, Bhadrak, Kendrapara and Jagatsinghpur. People in coastal regions of Odisha and West Bengal have been asked to remain indoors from November 8. All schools, Anganwadi centers and other educational institutes in Puri, Jagatsinghpur and Kendrapara district in Odisha have been closed for next couple of days due to the forecast of heavy rainfall accompanied with high intensity winds. The storm had brought torrential rains accompanied by strong winds for the capital city of Kolkata in the past 24 hours. According to the latest data available in the last 2 days, the city has received a whopping 104 mm of rain along with the wind gusting up to 50 to 70 km per hour. Meanwhile, the coastal area of West Bengal such as Digha, Howrah, Hooghly, 24 Parganas, Midnapur, were witnessing winds excess of 100 km per hour during the time the storm was tracking West Bengal. Not only West Bengal but the state of Odisha too had to bear the brunt of this storm. It has resulted in the large-scale damage in the form of uprooted trees, electric and telephone poles, crop damages and the Jagatsinghpur. It has resulted in large-scale damage in the form of uprooted trees, electric and telephone poles, crop damage in Jagatsinghpur, Kendrapara, Bhadrak and Balasore district of Odisha. Lightning strikes are to be watched out for which may be damaging. Moving northeastward further, it would be hard for the northeast states of India as a depression. However, this would be not before Sunday morning. Talking about rain figures, Kolkata has recorded 72 mm in 6 hours until 8:30 p.m, Diamond Harbour 75 mm and Digha a whopping 93 mm. Extremely heavy rains are likely with damaging lightning strikes. That's all for now. For more news updates, stay tuned with us. It's Tomorrow News, Jeet Dolakia. For more weather updates like this, please subscribe to our channel.